Corrales, so they're going to get all the support from the home crowd, as you can imagine. The officials already on court one. And there's how the women's doubles draw is panning out. So the top seeds safely through. Could be Super Jericho and Terry Panachai that lie in wait for the winners of this match. Meeting between these two
red color
women's doubles pairs.
Receive who's going to receive? Bianca is going to receive. You are going to serve. Who is the server? Kiharu going to serve. Okay, and this one? Okay.
So let's give you some information then on these players, starting with the Japanese pair, Chiharu Shida, 5'4". She's part of a pair that are now ranked 7th, that is their best. Only lost 4 of 25 matches this year, is an excellent record. And of course, they had a brilliant time in Bali recently. They won the Masters, they won the Open. And they only lost to Kim and Kong in the World Tour Finals final 10 days ago. Matsuyama is 23. Won their first title, these two, Vietnam International. Oh, sorry, in fact, that was Shida won with Fukushima, with Yuki Fukushima back in 2016. But the pairing with Matsuyama has been, well, a revelation, really. Well, they're going to have the crowd support, the pair on the other side of the net, but how much good that'll do them, we'll see, because all the statistics say they really should be outclassed here by the Japanese pair. Matsuyama and Shida didn't play yesterday. They had a bye through from the first round. There's Beatriz Corrales. 29 she is. They're ranked 63 in the world, which is their best. 1-8 and lost 8 so far this year.
Ready to play?
Azurmendi, you see there, we saw her playing singles on Sunday. She was at the Olympics. A walkover in their first round. So first taste of action at these championships for both these pairs. Tio Kenju is the chair umpire, and he will be assisted by service judge from Denmark, who is Jesper Larsen. There he is. Stand by then for the umpire's introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Clara Azurmendi and Beatriz Corrales, Spain. And on my left, Nami Matsuyama, Chiharu Shida, Japan. Chiharu Shida to serve to Beatriz Corrales, level. Play.
So here we go in this women's doubles round of 32 match. Japanese starting heavy favourites.
Service over.
But every point the Spanish pair win will be greeted with that kind of reception. Boy, how we've missed having fans inside stadiums. We really have. Well, it's been quite a positive start from the two Spanish women here. Nice change up there using the quick serve. Genuine power from the back of the court from Shida. Keep applying that kind of pressure, it's going to make life tough for the two Spaniards. Sounds like we've got some youngsters enjoying the badminton, judging from the pitch of the cheering. There you go. Standing on ceremony there, Shida, quickly in for the kill. But as long as they can stay competitive on the scoreboard, two Spanish women, that might sow the odd seed of doubt in Japanese minds.
Service over. 5-4.
Problem was when they spotted an unguarded area at the back of the court. So after a promising start, was 4-4, the Japanese pair have rather assumed control in this opening game. Yeah, lovely touch. She's got a good reach, Azurmendi. She's 6 foot, but no chance she was ever going to get to that.
Okay. Thank you. Hold on. Play.
So a very healthy lead for Matsuyama and Shida as they go for the interval. 11 points to 4. There's just no let up, is there, for Azurmendi or Corrales? Great early return in that point by Azurmendi. Almost seemed like an afterthought. She put a racket there. Somehow kept the rally going, but to no avail. Great work this time from Matsuyama.
14-6.
Sound judgment.
15-6.
Getting tested every point, aren't they, at the moment, Azurmendi and Corrales. Japanese pair just four points away from confirming this opening game. Oh, well done, well anticipated. Good stuff from Azurmendi. Just realised very late, Corrales, that was going to drop on the line. And of course, by then it was too late to rectify the situation. Longest rally of the match. It was wonderfully entertaining too, but in the end, an inevitable outcome.
20 game points.
And now, 12 game points for the Japanese pair.
score is over 9-20.
Points to 9 in a little matter of 15 minutes.
First game won by Nami
Japanese pair lead by one game to love.
Got one, 20 seconds. Second game. Level.
So is there a way back into this match for the Spanish pair? Have to be a real turnaround tactically, you suspect, for that to happen, because they were pretty dominant. Two Japanese in that first game. Good get that by Azurmendi. What a pity for the Spaniards, because they were really competing in that rally, and then just one loose shot set up the very easy kill. And that's the thing, when you play a pair obviously inside the world's top 10, you don't need a second invitation to take that kind of an opportunity. Just wide, but they are going to challenge it.
Clara Azurmendi challengers call out.
They actually worked the angle well. They didn't need to hit the line there. That's the irony of it. Well, they've been a winner inside the line. Let's see what Hawkeye says. No.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Three love play. Four love.
Well, they're on the board in game two, which will no doubt be a relief for them. Oh, beautiful shot. Beautiful shot.
Two, four.
Corrales played a full part in that rally as well. It's just the Azurmendi winner. Might sound odd when you look at the score, 21-9 and now 6-3, but I don't think those two have played badly. They really don't. They've been right in a whole succession of points, and then just one slip, one error. Oh, lovely. Perfect piece of deception from Matsuyama. Hope they don't get too distressed just looking at that scoreboard, because it certainly doesn't show the effort that they put in. I think it's a little flattering to Matsuyama and Shida. Obviously they've been the better pair. What's that?
one is over. 4-8.
Easy kill that time for Shida.
Service over. 9-4. Service over, 5-9.
Good blocking there by Corrales, and that was instrumental in helping Azurmendi secure the point for the Spanish pair. Well, another example. I mean, they should have won that point, really, as Azurmendi and Corrales. They end up losing it.
10-6.
But certainly nowhere near as comfortable for the number seven seeds in this second game as it was in the first, albeit they lead by 10-6. That they might well have wanted to. Doesn't matter in the end, and it's a 5-point lead at the interval, but not quite as straightforward as the scoreline would suggest. Nonetheless, in total control at the moment, Matsuyama and Shida. So this is the point of no return as far as Azurmendi and Corrales are concerned. Have to produce some kind of an heroic fight back if they want to stay in this year's World Championship. You let Azurmendi get that arm going from that range, you are going to be in trouble. Oh. Matsuyama stepping in.
Service over, 12-7.
I think she's been very proactive, Beatrice Corrales. Really supported her more well-known partner very admirably. And now a few errors from the Japanese pair. Certainly not over. I might be smiling away, but they've just been asked a couple of questions now, Matsuyama and Shida. Oh, what a pity. She had everything right until that point.
49.
Inexplicably, next probably the easiest shot of the rally.
Ready?
She was forcing the two Japanese into some really desperate scrambling just to keep the rally alive. In the end, they were rather handed it on a plate. Over the head of Matsuyama. Turned out to be the perfect lob. Delicate touch.
Service over, 15-10.
Beautiful angle.
Service over, 11-15.
Going down without a fight, which is great to see. this long.
16.
Corrales nets at the net, and now the scoreboard has a distinctly worrying look from a Spanish point of view.
Shida,
late decision never works, and just 3 points away now from a place in the next round for the number seven seeds. Just briefly, when it was 15-12, you thought maybe Azurmendi and Corrales could find a way to pressurise their opponents, but it hasn't really materialised, at least not yet, and they're running out of time.
19, 13, 19.
There's the fan club. They're the youngsters who've been making the noise every time the Spanish win a point. Could get, but it won't help them, and it's match point, seven of them now for Matsuyama and Shida. So that's it, 21-13. Rather an anticlimactic ending, truth to tell. Just 39 minutes the match time, and in the end, very straightforward for the Japanese and their mascot there. A little furry toy in the bag. 21-9, 21-13, the final reckoning. Not sure that that really gives any indication of the effort and the application that the two Spaniards put in, Azurmendi and Corrales, just obviously up against a much higher ranked pair, and they win, as confirmed there, 21-9, 21-13, in 39 minutes on court. They've both got little toys. Is that Goofy? I think it is. Other Disney characters are available. Other non-Disney characters are available. And also available will be Herbing Zhao and a Merry Batterman. That's our singles offering on the women's side. And that's next. We'll be right back. women's singles between Herbin Chow of China and Marie Batterman of France. Just actually waiting for the officials, are not there yet on court one, but as if by magic they're about to appear. And here's how the women's singles draw has panned out. So it's either Blichfeldt, or probably Blichfeldt you would think, will meet the winner of this one.